Hello, welcome back to Inside Gaming Daily for Tuesday. Happy Tuesday. Let's talk about Black Ops Cold War, a game about knowing your history, or some of your history. Is that what this game is? I thought it was about going...
Yep, you're my favorite rapper.
Thank you.
Ding, this is why we need to know our history, because none of this is accurate.
Can we get a quick ping from an M1 Garand reload?
Sure.
Barrett 50 cal.
The pistol that my uncle keeps in his bedside table.
Last week, Activision showed off the new teaser trailer for Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. There wasn't any gameplay, but it used a bunch of compelling historical footage, newsreels, and interviews to set up their upcoming game that pits the U.S. against Soviet Russia.
One last time.
Mr. Gorbachev, put that wall back up.
Just keep it there.
Keep that wall there.
You might remember that the tagline for the trailer said, "Know your history or be doomed to repeat it." The trailer featured lots of footage of civil unrest, including a very brief clip of footage from the Tiananmen Square protests in 1989 in China.
There's about a 1 second clip of student protesters attacking an armored vehicle, and not surprisingly, the Chinese government noticed. Oh, nothing escapes the eagle eye of those bastards. Kotaku reported that the trailer was quickly blocked in China, and while nobody knows exactly why, it's a very safe bet that it's because China's more of a fan of Battlefield. Well, no, it's probably the Tiananmen Square footage.
I mean, they're generally not okay with anything that isn't just like aggressively pro-China.
It's not a bunch of kids and basketballs, then we don't want
okay,
it.
Okay, that's dope though.
I know, it is pretty cool.
I was like, the minute quarantine's over, I'm gonna see if I can do what those Chinese kids were doing with those basketballs.
Because the ruling Communist Party always blocks any mention of the protests and the subsequent government crackdown that killed a lot of demonstrators. So that's to be expected because, like we said, China is an authoritarian government and lots of companies self-center like that in order to do business over there. Might not be the morally right thing to do, but lots of companies choose censorship in pursuit of the almighty dollar.
They had earthquakes in China a few years ago. It was when I was still in high school. The Chinese government was basically censoring the information that went out about the earthquakes and how many people died. So my sister and I were at home while my mom and stepdad were in China. We didn't hear from them for 3 days, but we were told that 40 Australians had died.
Oh, cool. Good.
Whoa.
We're like, they're probably fine. Okay, it's day two. They're probably fine. They might be fine. I don't know. Don't be in China when there's a natural disaster. Difficult to predict, but try.
Try not to be anywhere during a natural disaster.
Parents do be anywhere, huh?
Fires in California right now.
Fire tornadoes in California
it's our fault.
Right now.
We shouldn't have been here.
Lightning sieges.
Quite bad. Quite bad.
What'll the Democrats think of next? Am I right?
Anyway, the story gets worse. Not only did Activision pull the Cold War trailer in China and replace it with a new, shorter one, they did the exact same thing for the rest of the world, too. So now nobody has to see those messy, pesky pro-democracy protests where thousands of people were killed by the government.
Know your history, unless it's history that the Chinese government doesn't want you to know.
So yeah, this is all irony on a base level, but you can still get a hoot out of it, just if it weren't so dang sad. It's sadly the latest display of a company kowtowing to the Chinese government, but the remarkable thing here is that they didn't just self-censor for China, they did it for the rest of the world too.
Not to sound conspiratorial, but it's an example of just how much control the Chinese government exercises, not just in its own country, but globally.
Get this conspiracy theory bullshit out of here!
There's a long history of companies taking pains to not offend China, especially gaming.
Right. The thing about gaming is that specifically a lot of the censorship people don't know about. Like, I know of studios, AAA studios, who are in talks with Tencent, and some of the things that Tencent would require would be the characters must have lighter skin colors when you bring them to China and also larger breasts. They're a bit too black.
Can we do anything about this surfboard?
It is, yeah.
Basically, earlier this year, it was discovered that YouTube had been secretly deleting comments that were critical of the Chinese Communist Party, which has ruled over China since taking power in the late 1940s.
And we've talked before about how Hollywood regularly will make changes to appease China, like the poster for The Force Awakens with that tiny little itty-bitty fin.
I wonder why. I can't think of anything that would...
Oh! He's black.
Oh, right.
But they did still have him on the poster.
And that's a huge win. That's a huge win.
Big win for,
I don't like it. I don't like it.
feels icky, doesn't it?
But video game companies do this type of thing too, taking drastic measures so as not to offend China and its massive market of players. Most famously, last year, Blizzard suspended a Hearthstone player from competitive play after he voiced support.
All right, Zach, we've all had our fun.
Okay, cool.
Apologies, you may continue.
Most famously last year, Blizzard suspended...
I'm supporting the Hong Kong protesters.
They punished the two shell casters who were present at the time, too.
Come on, gang.
Let's sell some newspapers.
God, I'm so sorry, Zach. You just said support.
Most famously last year, Blizzard suspended a Hearthstone player from competitive play after he voiced support for Hong Kong protesters. They punished the two shoutcasters who were present at the time, too.
That makes sense, right? Because they were in relatively the same space as him.
Patrick, you have to understand they were accomplices.
Right, because they hid under a table. So that caused a massive public outcry against Blizzard, who seemed to be siding with an authoritarian government over free speech. They did like this goofy teary-eyed apology, but the ban was kept in place. Nothing was really changed. Jab did cry, though, so everyone decided that all was forgiven. That was a weird event to be at.
It was very strange.
Very weird.
Oh, yeah, you guys went, didn't you? How big were the protests?
Tiny.
Small.
Minuscule.
Oh.
They were small. There was an energy about the place, though.
Anyway.
Extra, extra! Blitzchung banned! Prize money revoked!
Just holding up a laptop with Kotaku on it.
But yeah, obviously Blizzard's apology didn't really mean anything because they still have a whole lot of business dealings with China and clearly didn't want to offend the government, thus being cut off from its massive base of players. Oh, and they're building the mobile Diablo model with Chinese developer NetEase, which I keep feeling like is worth mentioning. They got rid of witch doctors, aka... Wow, I wonder why there are no black characters in Diablo.
That's right, that's right.
China even banned Animal Crossing in the country after it was used by Hong Kong residents to stage protests against the regime. I mean, yeah, no video game wants to cut itself off from China. The player base, just the sheer amount of money.
Before we get into that, though, let's chat about one of the only VPNs that actually works in China, ExpressVPN. Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by ExpressVPN. Look, when you use the bathroom, you know, close the door behind you, right? So why would you let people look in on you when you go online? Using the internet without ExpressVPN is like using a public restroom and not shutting the door behind you. Did you know that your internet service provider knows every single website you visit? What's worse is they can sell this information to ad companies and tech giants who will use your data to target you. If you ever wonder why you're getting those weird, super specific ads after visiting a website, there you go. ExpressVPN puts a stop to this. It creates a secure, encrypted tunnel between your device and the internet so that your online activity cannot be seen by anyone. I have ExpressVPN on all my devices. I got it on my phone. I got it on my tablet. I got it on all of my computers, of which I have too many. It even works on routers, so everyone who shares your Wi-Fi can still be protected even if they don't have ExpressVPN. This guy uses it too. And using it is just as easy as closing your bathroom door. You just fire up the app, you click one button, and you're protected. ExpressVPN is the world's number one rated VPN by CNET, Wired, The Verge, and countless others. So if you're like me, and you believe your online activity is your business, secure yourself by visiting expressvpn.com/inside today. Use my exclusive link, expressvpn.com/inside, and you can get an extra 3 months free. That is expressvpn.com/inside. Thank you to ExpressVPN for sponsoring the show.
Back to Chinese investment in Western gaming companies. Tencent, for example, fully owns Riot Games, the maker of League of Legends. They also own 40%, I think it's a little bit over 40% of Epic Games, and thus Fortnite. They also own a piece of Bluehole, stakes in Activision Blizzard and Ubisoft, but that's just scratching the surface.
Oh, my surface has been scratched!
Oh, my surface!
My surface!
They also are the company that is typically the go-between for gaming companies like Nintendo who want to enter China. Meanwhile, they're also starting a AAA studio here in the US. Oh, and Tencent owns a 5% stake in Activision 2. Side note, this is not the first time, by the way, that the Chinese government has cracked down on a Call of Duty game. Black Ops 2 was banned from internet cafes a few years ago when the government found out that it included the bombing of a Chinese city.
As for the new Black Ops Cold War, we've also learned, thanks to a leak, that it's apparently a direct sequel to the first Black Ops, and it's set to be released in November.
November? A Call of Duty game? I don't know.
So the campaign will take place in the 1980s, which makes sense given the footage from the teaser. Take place in a variety of locations. You got East Berlin, you got Vietnam, you got Turkey, and the KGB headquarters in the Soviet Union.
Sorry, you mean the KGB?
All the hits.
In the Soviet Union.
And in glorious KGB headquarters in Soviet Union.
Ray tracing will be fully turned on the Xbox Series X game version.
Oh my god, I hope so. Love ray tracing, bro.
Soviet yes. Union have ray tracing since early
1998. Trace the rays, please. But really, a leaked bluff from the game says, as elite operatives, you will follow the trail of a shadowy figure named Perseus, who is on a mission to destabilize the global balance of power and change the course of history. Yeah.
Only you, Perseus, can change the course of history. Come closer. You are the chosen one.
Perseus is possibly a real-life figure. It is codename of the alleged Soviet spy who infiltrated Los Alamos Laboratory in the U.S. during the Manhattan Project, which was when we developed the first nuclear weapons.
Yay! Yeah. So glad we did that. Yep.
Perseus was never caught, though, and there's questions over whether or not they actually existed.
Ta-ta!
He swung his cape over
his
head.
He laid his finger aside his cherry red nose.
Ne'er to be seen again.
Oh, where'd he go?
He most likely did spy sh. I don't know that it says that they were a magician.
What is a spy if not a magician?
We never know if they actually even existed or not, but hey, this is a video game. We can make a whole game on flimsier premises, right?
I've heard they've made games about stuff that didn't even happen.
You're trying to tell me that Katamari Damacy is not real life?
I think Katamari might be based on a true story.
Well, I mean, if you just cover yourself in glue and then cover everything that rolls on you in glue.
That's not a bad idea for a business, actually. So, well, no.
Yeah, you need to keep applying a layer of glue to keep making the outside.
Hang on. You'll get so big that you can't put glue on yourself anymore.
So you have a room that you fill with objects.
A glue room. Oh, okay, an object room.
Yeah, and then you cover the person in glue, and they get in there, and they just start rolling.
Maybe we could have, like, a horse mascot. Anyway, we're going to learn more about the game tomorrow during a reveal event at 10:30 a.m. Pacific time. Don't expect any more Tiananmen Square footage, though. Or Winnie the Pooh. Not that I expected it anyway, but
Pardon me.
Hope for it, never expect it.
Do you have any Tiananmen Square footage I could borrow?
Oh, that's really good, Patrick.
You need to get the honey, Perseus.
Oh my god, I'm like a little bit creeped out.
Perseus.
Actually, there really are some pretty serious implications here. We acknowledge video games not as important as life-altering politics, but still, people outside of China may be impacted by this.
So first up, this story comes from The Verge, who discovered via human rights activist Jennifer Zhang that YouTube has been deleting certain Chinese language phrases that